Yes, today we are going to discuss the concept of parallel lines. Yes, what is parallel line? Parallel lines means which lines have a same distance at everywhere, like this. These will never intersect with each other, however they are produced. These lines are known as parallel lines. Now, with the help of parallel lines, I will tell all the angles, like how do you see ki corresponding angles, alternate angles, so many angles you can see. Now, if L and M are two lines, see, these are what? Parallel to each other. And P is a transversal. Transversal line is that line which is intersecting more than one line. If it is cutting one line, it is known as intersecting line. If it is cutting two, jab more than two, then it is known as transversal line. Where I have noted some names. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, how will you see ki which angles are corresponding angles? Now, you will never forget which angles are corresponding angles. Angle 1. Angle 5. See, same on L, same side, upside. And same on position M, who is there? 5. Just like L, M is there, whose position is taking off angle 1 on line this? Angle 5. And same position of 4 is taking with 8. 3's position is taking 7. 2's position is 6, means which angle is having position on L, same position it will be on M, then these are known as corresponding angles. Same line, same side, upside, left side, right side, this is known as corresponding angles. Second is alternate, totally change. Alternate angle is firstly divided into two types, interior alternate and exterior alternate. Alternate is divided into two types, interior and exterior. Now, interior alternate angle means 3 and 5. See how are these are alternate. See, this line is what? L. And what is the position of 3? Left side, downside. And now you will see the position of 5. Upside, right side. Totally different. 4's position is same. 6. How? This is on L. Right side, downside. Left side, upside. So these two angles are known as alternate. Angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Angle 4 is equal to angle 7. If you know any angle from them with the help of alternate interior angle, you can find others. If this is 70, this will also be 70. If this is 40, this is also 40. Means any example I am taking. If angle 1 you know, then you know ki that angle will be 5 also. Why? Because both angles are what? Corresponding angles. Next is vertical opposite. Firstly, I am telling exterior also. Exterior angles are those angle which is outside. Angle 2, angle 8, angle 1, angle 7. Same concept is here also. Angle 2 is upside on left side. Now in on MC, right side, downside. You are seeing it upside. This is downside. 2, 8, 1, 7. Now vertical opposite. Vertical opposite angles are those whenever two lines are intersecting in cross form. This angle is equal to this. If A is here, then this will also be A. If it's 60, this will also be 60. If this angle B, this will also be B. Means these are known as vertical opposite angles. So remember it. Vertical opposite angles. Sometimes it can be in any form. Then you will see this line here and this line. Sometimes it is cancellation by this, but you will see this line is produced here. This line is produced here. So this angle will be your this angle. So by producing you will see. So vertical opposite angles are also equal. Next one is co-interior angles. Co-interior angles are those which are on same side and between the parallel sides. Just like see, these lines are parallel and between them, this angle and this, the sum of these two is known as 180. This is known as co-interior angle. Consecutive interior angle is also known as co-interior angles. Sum of this also, this one and this one. Angle 4 and angle 5 180, angle 3 plus angle 6 is 180. I have taken 4 and 5 here, that's why. Angle 4 plus 5 180, angle 3 plus angle 6 is equal to 180. These are co-interior angles, just consecutive interior angles between the parallel line on same side. Next is linear pair. Linear pair, I know this is very much important concept. This is a pair. Two angles, when they are making 180, this is known as linear pair. When two angles sum is making 180, they are known as linear pair. See, they are both making 180. 3 and 4 also, 2 and 3 also, 1 and 4 means half circle if they are making on adding. This is known as linear pair. So many pair you can make. Let us discuss some examples. Find x, y and z from the given figure. You know if this one is 70, its vertical opposite is y. 70 will be y. Now you know 70 and x both are making a line, then their sum will be 180 because of linear pair. Yes. So with the help of this you got x is 110. Now you will see x and z both are vertical opposite. So z is also 110. Next one is find x and y. You have given this figure. See, this angle is given and you know ki they are making half circle. So linear pair they are preparing. So with the help of linear pair you got x is 120. Now exterior angle property is that if any angle is produced, any side is produced, then outer angle is equal to the sum of interior opposite angle. Interior opposite, this angle's production is here na? So you will not take this one, you will take them. So y plus 30 is equal to 60. And now y will remain same, 30 is subtracted from there. So you got a, I'll tell you one more example. Suppose this is here and you have given this. This is 30 and this is 20 and what is this? Then by exterior angle property you can tell this angle will be 10. Very good, because their sum will be is equal to outer side angle. I hope you got. This is for the linear pair, consecutive interior angles, vertical opposite, corresponding and alternate. Only when lines are parallel, then you can say these angles are equal. Corresponding angles and alternate angles, these are dependent on parallel lines. I hope you will get this concept. Thank you. Have a nice day.